cold. Do you have the safety on that thing?
Safety? I don't have the safety on. Why do I need the safety?
It's a gun.
It's a fake gun. You know I wouldn't walk through the shop with a real one, but I gotta mess with you guys, you know, keep you on your toes.
Looks pretty real.
Yeah, it looks awesome though. But this scope is actually real. All right, so this scope is actually from IR Defense, from Scott. I just went and visited him, and he only has the lenses. But the main body right here, he does not have. He has like maybe 12. So we have to machine the body, which is the most complicated parts. So I told him we're gonna get it done.
How many days did you give him?
Thursday. It's Monday now till Thursday. That's about 72 hours.
Wow. That's not gonna happen.
There's no way.
We got customers. We're gonna take care of them. Some people might just have to like come in at night and do what they gotta do, okay? But if we work together, we can get it done. So we just got this incredible 3D printer from Stratasys. It's the Fortis 250 MC. We brought it in here to actually help us out with our tooling and our manufacturing. So I just took Scott's part from IR Defense. He gave us a 3D model, and now we are 3D printing. All right, guys, check out that bad boy right there. Go ahead and make sure that everything is dialed to the print and the solid model.
So Tyson's writing the program right now. I just got the material from Zach. I'm gonna go ahead and get my tools. I'm gonna get them all set up in the machine. I got my turning tools for the outside, my boring bars for the inside. I gotta get them locked down real tight. They can't be loose at all. Part could come flying out of the jaws, the tool could come flying out, cause a lot of damage, and basically halt production.
All right, setup is complete.
I'm just double checking the simulation one more time. Make sure there aren't any glaring errors in the program.
It's go time.
Now Tyson has programmed this pretty aggressively, so I'm gonna have to be careful when I come in and run this. I'm gonna have to make sure that all my decimal points are on the right spot, there's no rapids where there should be a feed, and all my cuts are exactly where they wanna be. I'm gonna have my hand right near that red button as it comes in and it cuts fast. I don't want to see that part get thrown. I don't want to see damage to the machine. I don't want to see damage to myself as an operator. And I'd like to see production go smoothly.
All right, I got this mill lot programmed with Autodesk Inventor. It'll show me all the tool paths, simulating everything. It'll let me know if there's any errors so we don't crash a $100,000 machine. I don't think Titan will be too happy about that. This all looks good. There's no errors. Got my soft jaws cut. I'm gonna take a 3-inch face mill, cut the part to size. Put a drill in there, rough it out for my 1/2-inch end mill. Make the pocket, check everything out, make sure it's dialed. And I'll keep working on the next operation.
What's up, Dana? You ready to go?
Yeah. Cool. Made the fixture.
Awesome. So it's just gonna slide right on there?
Yep.
Okay.
Got these features ready to run.
All right, so let's go run one. That looks good. It's gonna go pretty smooth, huh?
Yeah, it'll go smooth. Looks pretty good.
Yeah, man, it looks great. I like the surface finish. It's definitely good. And then it pops up this way, pops up this way. Yeah, it looks good to me.
I've got the final op done on this IRD scope. Got 100 parts to do. It's gonna be tight. Titan asked Brandon to pull an all-nighter, and he's gonna do it, so we'll probably get him out of here.
Four-day turnaround. Scott is gonna see these parts and he's gonna be super happy. He's gonna get his shipment out. And I'm just excited to see his face when he sees these parts.
So let's check it out, Titan.
Well, it is all perfection.
Of course. Really good job.
Hey, Earl, how's it going? Hey, Titan's here. I don't know if you met Titan before.
Hey, Earl, nice to meet you.
Same here.
Awesome.
Well, the objective fits. Good first sign. Eyepiece fits. And this is the tightest piece. Fits.
Oh, snaps in perfect.
Snaps in.
There we go. Thank you, man.
Awesome. No problem.
That's outstanding.
Cool. So that's your guy right there, huh?
Parts were just perfect. I mean, these parts are just spec. Very impressive. Couldn't believe how well he did these and how fast it got done. And we fit checked the parts. Parts are going to the platers as we speak. scopes are going to come together probably ahead of schedule. So we're very happy. Customers very happy because they're going on deployment. So what you're seeing here is this sensor right here is actually inside of the weapon sight itself. So you're looking at a temperature difference of the seam out there. This is the same picture that you're going to see inside the weapon sight when we fire it later. Now, Fleur is actually an American-made company. They're made right here in California and Idaho. They even use Haas CNC machines there to make some parts.
Wow, that's awesome.
Hey, Chris, how you doing?
Hey, Scott. How's it going?
Good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
Thanks for coming out.
Thank you.
I'm Titan, man.
Chris, nice to meet you.
Hey, nice to meet you. Thanks for inviting me out here. This is awesome.
Stoked you're here.
Yeah. Tell us what you got here.
It's going to shoot an AR-10 based platform with the IR Hunter.
This is it. These are the parts right here that you machine.
Wow, that's incredible. Yeah, I can't wait to see it work.
You ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
You ready, Chris?
Be awesome.
I'm ready.
All right, let's do this.
Cool.
All right, Chris, let's see what this can do.
Yes, sir.
What do you think? You think the scope's accurate enough? Think we can ship these to our soldiers?
Incredibly accurate, and I definitely would have used it overseas.
Good job, man. Good job.
You designed it. It's all American built.
Absolutely.
Good job, man.
Thanks for coming out here.